Hello, my name's Ian Town. I'm the Chief Science Advisor here at the Ministry of Health. Today we're going to be talking a little bit about some of these new COVID variants that have been in the news a lot over recent times. We've all become aware that there are some new variants of this virus being discovered and described, particularly in the United Kingdom, but also more recently in South Africa. So viruses change all the time. It's part of their natural behavior in the real world. What happens is that viruses are constantly mutating. That is, that their DNA is being adjusted, and each of these variants either confers an advantage or it doesn't in terms of its evolutionary biology. So if a variant occurs, if a change in the genome occurs which doesn't confer any real advantage to the virus, becoming more transmissible or having other effects on humans, then it will tend to dissipate and won't be part of the next wave. What we do know is that if it confers an advantage, particularly around transmissibility, it will tend to become the dominant variant in that community. And this is what we've seen, where the new variant has now been discovered in a number of other countries, including here in New Zealand. What we know about the virus so far, these new variants, is although they seem to be transmitted more rapidly, they are not causing more severe COVID symptoms or more severe outcomes in those who are infected. The only problem with that is, as more and more people becoming infected, there is a risk that an increasing number overall will end up in hospital or with more severe condition, more severe disease. This is a very important question around whether or not this virus is more contagious or not. The weight of scientific evidence so far is definitely yes, and we've seen that with the explosion of cases in the southeast of England. The actual degree of increase in transmissibility looks to be about 50%. Yes, so we've been doing whole genome sequencing here in New Zealand for a long time now. That's been incredibly helpful in terms of understanding the pattern of change in the genome of the virus. So far in New Zealand, we've identified about 30 cases of the new variant, and all of those are in people that have arrived from overseas. Not just the UK, but mainly from the United Kingdom, where this was first discovered. So in terms of protecting family and whānau, the message hasn't really changed at all. The key thing is to be alert for any symptoms and to get a test promptly. And then in a day-to-day situation, keeping up those really basic messages, which is ensure that we protect ourselves if we're having a cough or a sneeze, we're washing our hands frequently, and we're staying at home if we're unwell. The other key thing, of course, that we've emphasised is to keep on scanning. That scanning process is absolutely critical to managing any future outbreaks. The question of whether or not the vaccine will work against the new virus is a very important one for our science community, and that's being carefully investigated both by the drug companies themselves, but also the wider science community. From what we know so far, and we've had some particular information provided to us from Pfizer, which is one of the vaccines New Zealand has purchased, we think that there is no risk so far that the vaccine will be ineffective. This will need to be closely monitored, because as we know with, say, the flu vaccine, there do need to be adjustments from time to time if the virus undergoes more significant changes.